No, 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 no. Bad game. Stop lagging. Formally join the team, but we need your help to destroy the Mask of Dark Earth. Hi, Ahoa. Your objective is to take out the gyrocopter while it's refueling. Huh, I know. Glad to hear you're up to it. If that's what you say. How do we know he's not just going, help me, these guys are making me do this shit. Kuro's like, what the fuck's a helicopter? I haven't seen any of this shit since living in the mountains. No! I may have to reboot the game out of safety. Because that was like two times in a very short amount of seconds. Oh, it's working. Okay. As long as it's working, man. As long as it's working. Well, there's an issue, Bentley. He's gone. What did he want me to do? Oh, fuck. I don't remember.
The mask. It's sure to take the bait. We got a situation.
Oh no.
Looks like Carmelita finally managed to catch up.
Rat! We can't stop the operation now. We'll just have to give her a wide berth.
Roger, oh what?
Flying wide berth.
Quit horsing around and look out for the mask. It's close. I can feel it.
Haida! Hoorada!
Here I come, master!
Carly is looking very confused here.
Did you get it? Is the mask gone? Sly, can you see?
Can't tell from here. I'll move in.
Uh-oh.
Cooper, thought I'd find you here.
Carmelita, you've got a little something on your face.
It's not nice to make fun of a girl's looks.
Maybe I should smash you!
Oh, fuck!
Now, that's not nice.
Carmelita, not, friendly.
Bentley, could use a little help. How about putting a few of your sleep darts in Carmelarja here?
Carmelarja! Wow. Oh! Oh, fuck. Where is she? Okay. Oh, get out of the way! Fuck, she's quick. Oh, damn it. That didn't work. Damn it. Keep missing the opportunity. These damn Banacucom controls, why did you have to? Why couldn't they be the same as the running mechanic and shit? Like, ugh. There we go, fuck. She just run right into that thing. There we go. Got her. Nice. The Carmelita we all know and love, where she just fires like a maniac. Come on.
Finally, the darts are starting.
Why are you sizzling, Sly?
Or not. The chemicals in my darts must
there,
somehow
she's growing.
Interacting with the mask to make her even bigger.
Whoa, you're not kidding, Bentley. She's getting gigantic. Everyone head for the big truck. We've got to get some distance between her and us. She might shrink back down with time.
She might, but we don't know. Guru, do you have any idea? Oh dear, look at that shadow. Why does she? She's got a whole nother truck in her hand, guys. Her legs are clipping through us. Quality control. See, this is what happens when you have a year time frame. Say that again. What hurts? I noticed there, Murray. She sounds in such pain. It's kind of sad. No. We almost got her, guys. We almost got her. Oh, she's growing.
She's too huge. We can't outrun her in the truck.
How are you doing?
Yeah, sure.
Bad. We need
there's
a
dramatic pause, like right after he turns the doll.
Time to stop running and deal with the real problem.
I don't
think
she can run. Look at her slow-mo.
Dark Earth, and maybe we'll get back to Carmelita we all know and love.
I do not love her.
Okay, not the point.
Not the point. I do not love her.
We gotta find a way up there.
You're the climber, and I'm sure you've always wanted to get closer to her. Can't get much closer than climbing up her bootlaces.
It's not a crazy idea.
Oh yeah, it's crazy.
Got a better idea?
Be careful with that scripting there,
fighting robot.
Developer.
Sorry, I'm gonna have to go with the bootleg.
Where are we gonna get a giant robot there, Murray? Mecha Godzilla is not gonna fly out of the sky here.
Watch out! Carmelita's troops are en route.
Really? Are you gonna fuck with us? You okay there, Sly? Kind of, having a fit there.
Push.
Ooh, foot! Boot, giant foot! Oh, gosh. Is she gonna have any memory of this? Oh, no. Stop. There we go. Try the mask off. Oh, that's kind of terrifying. How do the mercenaries know to shoot it? Oh, wow. The mercenaries died with it. Well, shit. It's gonna be tough for Carmelita to deal with. It's Halloween. No, it's March.
Carmelita just lay there, unconscious, hopeless on the desert floor. Being gentlemen, we kept watch over her throughout the night.
Her camera proved to be a real source of entertainment as we took turns posing. Didn't want her to go home empty-handed. Morning broke, and we got a clear view of the landscape. It was beautiful, empty of the miners that had been digging and drilling into the sacred place. The moment was broken as Carmelita began to stir, and we prepared for another quick exit.
Evidence. Develop film immediately.
It wasn't just the three of us. For the first time in Cooper gang history, we picked up a new member. And the team would never be the same.
Bam. Mystic Force. Here we go. This is one of my favorites. Flight of Fancy. Hang on. Let me soak us up. 47%? Oh. Are you shitting me? Complete the rock climbing course. Make it safe without being damaged before time. Defeat 12 guards. Oh no. Wow. Well, I don't know what 100%ing this does. Okay. Anyway. Flight of Fancy.
Bentley was obsessed. Every night he'd pore over the blueprints to Dr. N's fortress, looking for a way to get into the Cooper vault.
Oh my gosh, there.
He soon came to the conclusion that there was no way inside unless the gang picked up a dedicated RC specialist. An expert who had mechanical and piloting skills far exceeding his own. After weeks of searching chat rooms, he finally found someone who could keep up with him intellectually. A gearhead genius out of Holland named Penelope. She politely declined our invitation to join the team, saying she only works for the best. Apparently, her idea of the best was her boss, the Black Baron, a big-time dogfighting champ up there in Holland. He's so good that he's even set up an international competition.
This was another favorite of mine.
To attract worthy opponents.
I love the airplanes. It's so cool. In fact, this was like one of the big sellers of this game was the airplane. What's
up? Sent us a counteroffer. If our gang could manage to beat the Black Baron at his own game, then she'd know we weren't just a pack of jokers, and therefore, worth her time. So, we got busy. With no time to lose,
where the fuck did we get
Murray
a plane?
To put a plane together, while I got my pilot license the fastest way possible.
Oscar Piggy.
We'd prove to this Penelope that the Cooper gang was up for the challenge, even if we were making it all up as we went along.
Obvious Photoshop. Then again, look at fucking Bentley's picture, too. His picture's full of lies.
Flight of Fancy.
Challenges. Get fucked. I don't want to do challenges, man. Wow. Carmelita's here.
I
Guru. I do like, though, they, in this one, while they show you the map, they show everybody having to get to their, safe house.
If we're gonna succeed at this year's Aces competition, we'll need to learn who we're flying against.
What? They keep the flight roster a secret?
Correct. In years past, competitors would go out at night and sabotage each other's planes in preparation for the next day's dogfight.
I get it. So now they keep the lineup a secret, and no one knows who to mess with.
Precisely. Looks like you're a good pilot, but we've only got one plane, and you'll be up there against dozens of bogeys.
You know, normally I'd make some sarcastic remark about how overwhelmed I am by your confidence in me, but those are some grim odds. And, well, you know, I'm always up for some sabotage.
Glad to hear it. Now, the roster is kept secret from the pilots, but not from the event staff.
Do we have a mole on the inside?
Our friend, Dimitri, has been hired to give color commentary during the dogfights. He'll know where the roster's hidden. Scout him out somewhere in the hotel lobby. But be careful. If you start a fight with the other pilots, we'll be kicked out of the competition.
Sure. We all play nice until tomorrow. Then we blow each other to bits at 300 feet.
Yeah, again, we start to question, So dark themes in this game. There's like a mini zoo on the outside of town. Oh, there's Dimitri. And it was so weird to just see this big ass reindeer caribou thing looking at me out of a car. Hi, Dimitri. You want to talk to me?
Dimitri? Funny seeing you here. Never
could you be any fucking
boy.
Bigger?
Like a dance floor with many lights. I have many profiles. Dig. Don't even try to understand the silky enigma of the
enigma.
Bentley seemed to think you might have a copy of the Aces flight lineup. That true?
And why should I talk to a two-bit Rudy Poot cracker box Rudy like Poot. You? Question mark in bold. Why?
I fucking love Dimitri. Question mark in bold. Why? Oh, I love him so much. Looks like I'll need to intimidate him a little. Maybe I should use a logical argument. Try to expose him. Fucking go for the throat.
You might want to think about talking, pal. I could always rat you out to the Black Baron. Then you'd be out of a job.
I'd have no job, and you'd have no another flight line. Go ahead, blow that whistle. I'll be seeing you in the loser's hot dog banquet.
Really?
We both know you're gonna tell me. You wouldn't have bothered showing up if you didn't want to talk. So, spill it.
I know, but to talk is like sitting on a electric chair. The Baron has eyes. Eyes and ears. Ears and fists! Dimitri will be discovered, and the jig is pitched!
Oh, fuck. Maybe I should compliment him, make him feel good, swear to keep it all a secret, promise to protect him. Last part sounds good.
If you talk, me and the gang will protect you. We're all in this together. You can count on us. You know our reputation.
That Baron is a big wheel. He'll roll all over us. Too many men he commands. We can't stop them. Too many to count.
But for fuck's sake. Stroke the ego.
Come on now, Dimitri. A man like you can deal with this Black Baron. You've got the best fashion sense of anyone I know.
Le fashion?
Le fashion?
Style? You're right. If I can outdress him, I can certainly outsmart him. All is told through clothes. Okay.
I don't know if Dimitri knows the Freddie Mercury line, I dress to kill.
Dimitri, which I'll collect in a few months of time.
Oh, favorite? Gosh, I fucked that up.
No small
this is going to be a great
like
joke, great pun.
My plant. No way, bro. This old school mafia blood pack favor, like movies, big time.
I dress to kill, but tastefully, is what I was trying to say. This guy's a real nut job. No. You don't say. Not sure I want to owe him. I could agree to favor if he was offering a bribe. Just agree to the favor.
Okay, Dimitri. Hook me up with the flight roster, and we'll owe you one.
Done! The bargain she has struck. To find flight roster, look behind one of the tacky paintings in Black Baron's
tacky painting.
It's hidden in secret safe.
Art decryption lock, huh? I know just the guy for the job.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, cool. More art decryption
lock.
Here comes
big cheese.
I bid you all a most flamboyant welcome, my esteemed comrade of the skies. Welcome, welcome to another year of the Aces competition. We've got teams here from across the globe. Canada, Belgium, Ecuador, Iceland, Korea, and many, many more. Not the least of which is last year's deadly runner-up, Team Mugshot. This time, we're gonna drill you jokers full of holes.
I remember as a kid,
now,
like, popping, jumping on the team.
What?
Some teams
Mugshot?
Have engaged in a little good-natured late-night hijinks.
Like when Team Canada stole Ecuador's parachutes.
Or when Team Iceland saw the landing gear off Korea's planes.
Or when Portugal put rat poison in Team Mugshot's coffee machine.
Yes, yes, that was all so very funny, but no more. You know the rules. No one, absolutely no one, is to leave the hotel after sunset. If my guards catch you outside, you will be beaten to within an inch of your life. No exceptions. This will be a fair competition.
Same as last year and the year before. I've got the scars to prove it.
I bid you all an exuberant and exaggerated farewell, pilots. Tonight, sleep like geese. And tomorrow, soar like eagles, eh? What?
What? What? All right.
They don't lock the front door to the hotel. This isn't a jail. But you heard the Baron. Once outside, things will get dangerous.
What day is it? Oh, it's the front door, ain't it? Oh, no. Oh, yes, let's change right in front of those two.
Careful, partner. The Baron's got plenty of guards on duty, and it's a long way up to his castle on the hill.
I can see that. Don't have to tell
Sorry,
me twice,
Pally.
Sir.
The
best in the business.
Tomorrow, where are all my guards? Asleep? Watching TV? I bother paying them at all if they're going to lounge about like common tourists.
Fuck. Oh, I know what to do. Ah! Stop. Stop being a fool there, Sly. Woo! Hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert.
I tell you, Christoph, the Aces pilots get better and better. We've got some real competition on our hands this year. Well, I'm not saying it's too much for Team Black Baron. No, 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 no. We've done a fine job training. Our pilots are in tip-top condition, the best lot without question, truly. I'm not just saying this, truly. This is going to be our finest victory ever. Yes, yes, tomorrow we'll witness some legendary dogfighting. Provided the other teams don't sabotage each other, when will they learn?
Okay. Top of the castle.
Sly! Hey, Sly! Sly, are you up there?
Yes.
Nope, sorry. Just us Black Baron goons.
Throw the switch and lower the drawbridge so that I can get up there.
Sorry, pal. I don't see any switch.
But there just has to be a switch. I can't get in the Baron's hangar from down here.
Hold on.
You
I
think
got
the
an idea.
A switch would be on the inside?
It's gonna fall.
Ah.
Medieval, but effective. Thanks, pal.
Sure thing. See you back at the safe house.
Whoosh. Woo! I'd be pissing myself if that ever happened to me.
If Dimitri's intel is accurate, the flight roster should be locked behind one of the paintings in this hangar.
Oh! Is that... I'll say that again there, Baron. Kinda died in the middle of your, spiel. Oh, that's Rajan's palace. Or, not his palace, but his hideout. What's that? Whole lot of nothing. Hello? 2, 2, 3. 2, 2, 3.
That safe was a bust. Try the other.
The one at the very corner. Memory serves me. Oh. What, is it not gonna spawn? Do I seriously have to get that one before I go over there? You're gonna make me bust things that don't even have things in them. 510. That was actually pretty quick. Oh. 510. Oh, okay. Never mind. I could have sworn there was 3 paintings, but no, I am wrong.
Okay, fellas. According to the Aces flight lineup, we'll be flying against Team Iceland and Team Belgium in tomorrow's semifinal round.
Wow, does that look
We've only
bush.
Got a single plane, while our opponents will be flying.
They look like,
You got that, guys? That's
those Russian dolls.
In order to give us a fighting chance, we'll need to pit these two teams against each other. First, Murray and Sly will paddle through the sewers beneath town to get access to
we somehow already have pictures of
Team Iceland's hotel room. Steal one of their trademark Viking helmets, then head over to Team Belgium's hangar. Vandalize one of their aircraft, then flap the helmet in order to frame Team Iceland for the damage. Next, Murray and I will steal one of Team Belgium's monogram handkerchiefs. Meanwhile, the guru will break into the Team Iceland supply truck carrying their lucky ice sculpture. Sly will steal the art and then place the handkerchief insinuating Team Belgium for the crime. Get it? We frame both teams so they'll be gunning for each other and not Sly in the semifinals. All the while, I'll be setting up defenses around the Team Cooper air hangar. You never know when one of the other teams might come looking to do us some harm.